Hello everyone, it's Farkad here, and in this video I'm going to cover everything that's changed or been removed from the forest. Now this is everything that I can think of. I've most likely missed some stuff. Now I've done a lot of videos on the forest and it would be too hard to go back through and change or mention what's actually changing the game. So this is more of an all-in-one. Now blue paint and orange paint has been removed from the game. You used to be able to craft it and paint your plain axe, crafted axe, and upgraded rock. Though I believe they removed it from the game because they probably intended to add it to every weapon, though it would have taken too much time. This was purely cosmetic. Deer skin can no longer be worn as armor. You used to be able to wear it as armor, but then they added the warm suit instead. It was terrible armor anyway. 10 stacks of deer skin could easily be removed in a couple of hits. You can no longer duplicate logs by placing a zipline into a cave entrance. This is when the zipline first came into the game. I made a video on it and they fixed it almost instantly. I've removed the video since, though here is footage of it happening. It was extremely efficient at duplicating logs. It had to do with placing a zipline from one end and wedging it into the crack of the entrance of the cave, if that makes sense. Now the method I came up with, I call it the Fark method, to be provocative, it allowed you to build floating structures, though they fixed it in the full release. You can still technically do it, but it's really tricky. It involved not snapping a floor to a rock pillar. It was quite confusing, though it was pretty useful. When upgrading weapon, you used to be able to place the upgrade where you wanted to. That has been removed as of the full release. I'm not sure why they removed it, though it was quite buggy. It would often remove your upgrades randomly. They would still be on the weapon, though you couldn't physically see them. It was a cool concept, though. You can no longer use a booze fire upgrade. You used to be able to place cloth and then place booze, and it would triple the burn length, and it would make the flame brighter. It was really, really good. Though they removed it, apparently it didn't make sense to them. Though I missed this one. This is why I used to say only place 29 upgrades. That's no longer relevant. Place 30, because this feature has been removed. I was really dirty when they removed this one. I loved it. When the machete was originally added, it was intended to take down stick trees in one hit, though that's no longer a thing anymore. It's all based on damage, so a modern axe will take it out in one hit, whereas a stick will take quite a few hits. The machete most likely will still take down stick trees in one hit, I think it does, but that was at its intended purpose, but they added stick tree damage instead. Now the animal magnet, I have no idea if it works or not. I haven't tried it in a very long time. I actually never used it. I just thought it was a cool mechanic, so I don't know if this one still works. I think it's more gimmicky than anything, and it's only viable on normal mode. On hard and hard survival, the animal spawns are reduced quite significantly, especially hard survival. Water collectors are now destructible. In season 3, I believe, I used them as walls a lot, and they were good for my prison trap, though they can be destroyed by mutants. They can't be destroyed by cannibals, I believe, though the wood target is still immune, as well as the animal trap. Speaking of the wood target, it used to use one blue paint, though when they removed blue paint, they just removed that requirement when you were building the target. Moving while power attacking was something I discovered quite some time ago, though I found out that if you had the ultimate cheat menu running, even if you weren't using it, it allowed you to move while power attacking. I wasn't aware of this when I first started my channel, so I gave out some fake news there, though I removed the video and I've clarified it in numerous videos. You can no longer build on top of houseboats for custom structures. You used to be able to place rock walls and stuff. I did this in season 1, though you can no longer do it. They wouldn't connect, it would just allow you to build a floating wall. It was kind of cool. The strength system has changed almost completely from the older versions. It used to work on good nutrition points, bad nutrition points, eating during a scheduled time. It was awful. It was absolutely awful. Though it is no longer a thing anymore. It works on calories. So if you've watched my older videos where I mentioned about good nutrition points and all that sort of stuff, that's completely irrelevant. Just focus on calories. Swinging your weapon while you have calories will raise your strength. Swinging your weapon while you don't have calories will lower your strength. Also, calories are only a system for hard survival. If you're in hard or normal mode, you don't have to deal with that. You just keep swinging your weapon. The prison trap idea I came up with using targets, that no longer works because cannibals can jump over targets. Though if you line the inside with water collectors, they can't jump them. However, just using targets as a prison trap will stop mutants from being able to get out most of the time. Though if you line it with water collectors, it'll stop cannibals. But mutants will be able to destroy the water collectors, so you technically have to have two different types, unless you've got building destruction mode off. But this is a good way to test damage and play around with the game and torture them and that sort of stuff. The catapult storage has been completely nerfed. Originally, it could store 32 different types of items. It was really good. You could store animal heads in there and use them for later on. Though you can't do that anymore. It only takes like 4 or 5 things. What it was really good for is if you're building a base at sea, you couldn't carry the head out there. So you could put it on the catapult on your boat and take it out there that way. But they removed it. It even used to store old pots. It was really good. Though they've just limited it to ammunition now. It's still useful for storing skulls though. Building off cranes is no longer possible. You used to be able to place like rock walls and stuff on the side of the crane, which would allow you to place a custom floor towards it. So you could use it as a bridge to get to your crane. And it's a real big pain to try and make this work now. You have to build it off the crane and work your way up. It's very tedious to do. I'm not sure why they added this one. Maybe because people were building things on the crane and the crane platform was colliding a lot. I did a video some time ago about invulnerable walls. It was the water collector target and the animal trap. Though, as mentioned, water collectors can be destroyed by mutants and targets can be jumped by cannibals. It was around this time I discovered that Endnight was actually watching my videos, trying to find all my exploits. With a large raft, you used to be able to build underneath the canopy area, like the stair sort of system. I don't know what the hell you'd call it. Though you can no longer do that, and it severely limits the amount of room you can build with on the large raft. Large rafts aren't worth building, in my opinion. Not anymore. Houseboats are the way to go. You can fit just as much on it, almost. And you don't have to have another person driving at the same time. The floating zipline method that I came up with, where you cut the floor underneath it, no longer works. Something's gone on with the mechanics of the game where they will explode when the logs reach the other end. Though you can build a gazebo and do the log catcher method that Zebulon came up with. That still works. That's still really good. I recommend you do that instead. There's been a lot of items and buildings that have received texture changes. They just changed the look of them. I've put up some of them here. There's quite a lot though. View at your leisure. They have definitely improved a lot of them. There is now two endings in the game. Now this one contains spoilers, but I'm not going to show footage of it. One finishes the game and unlocks creative mode. The other one allows you to continue playing, but it doesn't unlock creative mode. My advice is just before you open the vault door at the end, there's an orange tent. Save there. Go through, complete the game, get creative mode, then reload, and then finish the other ending. Take about an extra half an hour, depending on how good you are. That way you'll get creative mode and you'll be able to keep playing your save game. Now I'm going to cover some things that happened before I started my YouTube channel. The head effigy used to be in the game, though it's been removed and it was replaced by the custom effigy. The large drying rack was something that was in the game for quite some time. They changed it to the small drying rack, or the light version, because it was very difficult to place meat on it and take it off. The new one is a lot better, and the old one was very expensive to build. Wooden paths were in the game, though they've been merged in with custom floors. If you place a custom floor just normally on the ground, or places a wooden path. I've never messed around with them because they're quite expensive. I don't think it's very viable. Personally, I haven't found a use for them, though you may. In caves, climbing ropes have had an overhaul, so they've changed quite a bit. I think it's to make it easier to see them and to grab onto them, etc. Looks a lot better. It's a shame we can't build these though. Wooden steps used to be a thing with treehouses when they didn't have climbing ropes, though they were removed in the game pretty much straight away after the treehouse was added. This was a very long time ago. You can find it in version 0.07, 8, and 9, and it was removed in version 0.10. Map parts were removed from the game quite some time ago as well, and then they just added a full map that reveals as you're searching. You used to find the pieces, it was 4 pieces, and then you put it together and that's how you had the map. You didn't discover it as you were going along. This was an odd one. Map Cave 2 was a thing. It showed you some parts of Cave 2, though it's since been removed. This was one thing that I could never 100% confirm that was actually removed from the game. I did spend a lot of time trying to add it, but I couldn't find it, though there was nothing in the patch notes mentioning it. Though I am 99.9% sure it has been removed. There used to be about 130 passengers or something like that in the game, but it was significantly reduced. It was really buggy back then. I think you can still find one in Cave 5 just as you enter. There's a pilot there, and it registers part of the old system. I can't remember if that's been fixed or not. Frogs used to be in the game, but then they removed them. So you can still hear them, but you can't see them. They serve no purpose though. And finally, the dynamite cannibal. This was removed from the game pretty much as soon as it got added because it was deemed overpowered. Though if you compare it to the new worm mutant, Jesus, the worm mutant in most cases is more destructive. Imagine lobbing dynamite at your base. That's pretty much what the dynamite cannibal was doing. He was pretty overpowered. I don't think we're going to see him again. Apparently he's been removed completely, even from the game files, including the textures. Now that's all the things I can think of. No doubt I've forgotten some. If I was to cover every single change in the game, I would be here for a very long time. It would be about a 24-hour video because there's a lot of stuff that's changed. But this is the primary stuff since my YouTube channel has started, and some legacy stuff that happened a very long time ago. Anyway, if you can think of anything that I've missed, make sure you leave it in the comments. And if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Cheers.